Hello YouTube, Razul here, and as you guys know that WhatsApp recently announced its web version for WhatsApp Messenger. So this video is going to be about all of the things that you have to keep in mind before you use the Messenger and how to set it up on your PC. So let's get started. Okay, so before you actually get further in this tutorial, there are three things that you have to remember before you get into this tutorial. The first thing is that you should have an activated WhatsApp account on your number that you're going to use. Second thing is that you should have WhatsApp application installed and running on your phone. Right now, WhatsApp only supports Android, Nokia 60, Nokia 40, BlackBerry and BBM phones. So iPhones or Apple devices are not supported yet, so you should have an Android, Nokia or Windows phone before you get into this tutorial. So, and the third thing is that it's not a different application for your phone and a PC. That means it's just syncing your messages from your phone to your computer and vice versa. So it's not a standalone application differently made for a PC or separate for a PC, and instead it's an application or it's a syncing system that syncs your messages from your phone to your PC or the web client that they've designed. So what this actually means is WhatsApp should be running on your phone and your phone has to be connected to the internet while you're using WhatsApp on your PC. So your PC has to be connected to the internet and you have to set up everything that I'm going to show in this video. And your phone also has to be connected to the internet so that the web client can access the messages from your phone and sync it to the Windows or the application that WhatsApp has designed for the PC. But still, it would have been much better if you didn't have to connect your phone to the internet each time that you access WhatsApp on the PC. So let's get in the tutorial and see how it's actually done and how you set up WhatsApp on your PC. So first of all, if you don't have a WhatsApp account, download WhatsApp on your phone from the App Store or any store and then set up WhatsApp. It's really easy. And after you've set up your WhatsApp, all you need to do is you'll need to go to your Windows browser. You need to go to web.whatsapp.com. And after you go to web.whatsapp.com on your browser, you can use Chrome, you can use Opera, you can use Safari, and you can use any browser that supports this application. So after you go to web.whatsapp.com, go to your mobile phone, open your WhatsApp, and from your WhatsApp, just go to this small icon on the top right of the screen and click on WhatsApp Web. And after that, take your phone and scan the QR code on the screen like this. It'll take some time. And like as you can see on the screen as well, it shows all the chats. Keep your phone connected. WhatsApp Web connects to your phone to sync your messages. To reduce data usage, connect your phone to Wi-Fi. So your phone has to be connected to internet for you to continue using WhatsApp on the browser. So you can turn your notifications off. As you can see, I have not started any chats, so no chats are showing up. But this is how you use WhatsApp's web version. If you want to chat with someone, just click on new chat and select the contact that you want to chat with and send a message from here. So three things that you have to remember is you have to install WhatsApp on your phone and it has to be activated. And this is not a standalone application that's designed specifically for Windows as to run as a standalone application. So it's basically is a service that syncs your messages from your phone or your device to your browser or your computer. So you have to be connected on your phone to continue using WhatsApp on your browser, and the changes that you make on your web version of your WhatsApp get synced to your phone, and the changes that you make on your phone get synced to the web version. So that's it. So that's how you use WhatsApp on your PC, and this will get disconnected as after you disconnect the internet connection on your phone. Thank you for being here, and I hope this helps. If you have any issues, if you run into any kinds of problems or difficulties, just send me a message on Facebook or just comment, and I'll reply to your comments as soon as possible. If these videos have helped you guys, give it a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you. See you in my next video.